Hi, and welcome to a brand new video. In this video, we're going to be tackling the problem on the screen, where we're given an array of integers preorder, which is organized in a preorder traversal, and we need to construct the tree and return the root. So first, I'm going to explain binary tree and preorder traversal. A binary tree is where the numbers to the left are smaller than the current number, and the numbers to the right are greater than the current number. So for example, if we have 1 here, we can't have 2 here because left is less than the current value. Therefore, if we have, let's say, 8 here, then we can have 5, 1, 7, because remember, if it's binary tree, it needs to match the whole thing. So this here can't be 3, but it can't be 9 either because it has to be smaller than 8. So an example of this arrangement could be 1, 7. On the right hand side, it needs to be greater, so we could have 9, and this needs to be less than 9 but greater than 8. Since that's not possible, let's say we put 10 here, now we can put 9 here, and this is a good binary tree. How about preorder traversal? Now, I already talked about preorder traversal in a previous video, but because it's super important for this one, I'm going to re-go over it, and if you want more depth, go ahead and check that video out as well. So, in a preorder traversal, what you do is that you print the current node, and then you traverse left, and you traverse right. So print current, traverse left, traverse right. I'm gonna initial this SPC, TL, and TR. This is a really nice way of remembering it because compared to the post order and the in order traversals, all you need to do is rearrange the order you do these. I won't talk about that here, but if you're interested, go back to the video that I suggested earlier. So let's try doing a preorder traversal on our tree right over here. So what we're going to want to do is we're going to want to start at 8 because we print the current node first, and then we see we traverse left. So now we go down over here to number 5, and then we do the same rule. We print the current one, and we go ahead and traverse left. We print the current one, and because we can't traverse, now we go back up to root 5 so that we can go to the TR. So now we go down to root 7. And since there's no traverse there, we go back to root 5, back up to root 8. So now we completed this side of the branch. Time for TR again. We go down this path, we get to node 10. We print out 10, we traverse left first. And then we print out 9. Since there is no left or right here, we go back up to node 10. There's no right here, so we go back up to root 8. And now we're also done with the right side. So now that we have printed all the numbers inside our tree, this is the preorder traversal. So now that we've understood the concepts of a binary tree and preorder traversal, let's solve the question. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a global variable, and this is just going to hold the pre-order array so that when we traverse it through our second method, we don't have to continuously pass in pre-order, and therefore we save a little bit of space. And then all we need to do is create alternative method. I'm just going to call it recursive, but you should probably give it a more detailed name. And then here, I'm just going to return recursive of start to end. Start is where the current node is. So start would be the start bound. So before the start bound, we've already took care of that. And then the end is what is the other half of the array. So start ideally would be the left side, and end would have the right bound. This ensures that we don't repeat anything that we've already traversed through, or we are going to traverse through. And start here would be 0, and end would be preorder.length minus 1, because we haven't done any iterating, and therefore want to have the entire range available. And then here, all we need to do is say if start is greater than end, return null, because that means that our start is greater than our end bound, and therefore we've already gone through all the numbers inside that supposed range, and we don't need to do any more, just return null. Next up, I'm just going to create a variable with preorder of start. So we can create a tree node with this val. The reason we're doing this is because we do want to return a tree. As you can see in the prompt, construct the tree and return the root. So I'm creating a node with that value inside so we can build the left and right from there. The reason we do it with preorder of start is, remember, preorder traversal does print current and then left and right. So if we have a preorder start node, we can use the later values to determine which side's left and which side's right. But how exactly do we do that? Well, remember the definition of a binary tree. The left side must have lower values than the current node, which means the moment inside this range where it becomes greater is where we split from left to right side. So for example, if we have the current node of 5, and then we have the list 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, we know that this is where it splits into left are these three and right are these three, because we know that the right is greater than 5 and the left is smaller than 5. So all we need to do is say is while I is less than or equal to end, because we don't want it to go over our end bound, obviously, and preorder of I is less than or equal to val, all we need to do is continue iterating. Once we get the value that is that turning point, then it's pretty straightforward from there. Just have node.left is equal to recursive of start to I minus 1. And node.right is equal to recursive of I to end. So what we did here exactly is we found that splitting point, and then we say the left of the node is equal to what's returned in that left side range, and we're saying the right is equal to is what returned inside the right side of that range, because we split it at that middle point. And then all we need to do is return node. So just as a recap, we first create a node at the current value. And this is because preorder traversal prints the current node and then left and right. So we can take the current node and say that is going to be the root at that specific point inside the tree. And then we find the value in the rest of the range from start to end where it turns. So it goes from being less than this value to being greater than this value. And then lastly, we just say that the left is equal to the nodes inside that left range and the right is equal to the ones inside that right range. And right here, you can also do start plus one, but I recommend just doing start. So just change this to start plus one. So I hope this video was helpful and see you in the next video.